आंसर नंबर थ्री में बी डी एंड सी बी सी आर इक्वल परपेंडिकुलर्स, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म, आर इक्वल परपेंडिकुलर्स। तो बेसिकली दे हैव गिवन टू इंफॉर्मेशन, फर्स्ट इंफॉर्मेशन इज बी डी सॉरी बी सी एंड ए डी आर इक्वल, सो वी विल राइट दैट ए डी इक्वल्स टू बी सी। ओके, सेकेंड इन्फॉर्मेशन आर परपेंडिकुलर, व्हाट डू मीन बाय परपेंडिकुलर? व्हाट डू यू
तो
कॉल
जरा
दे आर एट 90 डिग्री। सो लेट्स रीड इट केयरफुली, आर परपेंडिकुलर टू अ लाइन सेगमेंट ए बी। ओके, सो बी डी आई एम सेइंग बी डी बी डी ऑलवेज ए डी, सो ए डी एंड डी सी आर परपेंडिकुलर टू ए बी, कैन यू सी दैट 90 डिग्री। सो देयरफॉर एंगल ए equals to angle B equals to 90 degree. This information is also given. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, show that CD bisect AB. Now, student write this statement. What do student write? CD bisect AB. Which you should not write. You should interpret the meaning of it and write in mathematical way. CD bisect AB. Who is getting bisected? AB is getting bisected. Yes, no?
Yes, sir.
So basically, BO equals to OA. That should you should write. Is this thing clear? Or should I repeat?
Yes. So we have to prove that BOA is equal to OA.
Yes. Yes. So you should not write statements. You should interpret the statement and write the meaning in mathematical way. BD. Sorry, CD bisect AB. So who is getting bisected? AB is getting bisected. So look at the figure. AB is here. So we will write AO equals to OB. So that I need to prove. So this is to prove. Now, proof. As we know, how can I prove that? Only way is if I am able to prove that this triangle and this triangle are congruent. Yes or no? So we will start by in triangle, any triangle you can take. So in here, they are talking about AD first. So take the AD triangle first. So ADO in triangle ADO and triangle CBO. Do you understand why I am taking these two triangles? Obviously, these are the two triangles which are being formed. But this information and this information is available in these two triangles. That's why I am taking. Because if the figure is complicated like the above one, then I have to decide which triangle I should take. Is this thing clear?
Yes, sir.
So
yes,
first
sir.
Thing is given AD equals to BC. Angle A equals to angle B. Here we will write given. Here I can write each equals to 90 degree. Two things are done. Third thing is important. Tell me the third thing. Anyone? Third
thing. Two lines are vertically opposite angle.
Yeah. So always remember, whenever you get a cross, these two angles are equal. Okay, one thing is you draw the figure and you write 1 and 2 and you use angle 1 equals to angle 2. Another is you directly write the name. So angle AOD equals to angle COB. Now, here I was using a single letter. Here I am using three letters. Can you tell me why?
So, because O is common.
Yeah. Vertex O is common. So, if I just write angle O, there is no clear indication which O I am talking about. This or this. Is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
That's why I have to write BOA and COB. So, that's why I'm writing full. So, whenever there is a complicated figure, so if I have to use this angle, angle B. But if you write angle B, it will be confusing. So, you write angle ABD. Okay? So, I hope this thing is clear. So three things are available now. Let us mark those things. I always mark those things in the figure so that I get an idea which property we are using. So we have used, and I mark only in one triangle. We have used this angle, this side, and this 90 degree. Can you tell me how these two triangles are congruent?
Yes, sir.
Tell me. ADO is congruent to triangle CBO. Which property?
The angle side.
Very good. Angle side. Okay. So these two triangles are congruent. Now, just check this information. Is these two sides available in these two triangles? BO is available here. And OA is available here. Can you see that? So I can use that. So AO is equals to OB by CP CT. I hope you understood how to present your work.
Yes, sir.